1, 2, 3, 4.
Hello, turtle.
Kiddo, hello. Tell us your story today. Deep in the ocean and over the rim, you're the hero in my dreams.
Oh my goodness! I'm really scared now. After so many thousands of miles in the ocean, here I am, for the first time, back to the same beach where my mom laid her 100 eggs over 30 years ago. I am going to lay my first nest tonight. Friends! Friends! Are you there? Are you with me?
Yes! Yes! Do not worry. We're here and you're going to nest all right.
No, no! I see some light.
Where? Where?
Over there, in the trees. Oh, the poachers come to get me and my clutch of eggs. I heard such horror stories. We lose so many mothers, so many babies to be our future generations. Lights confuse us. The older turtles told us to stay away from coastal lights. Only the ocean light is the right one to follow.
No, it's all clear. Come on, girl. We don't have all night. Surf up.
Happy nesting!
Now, now. How nice and yet how strange. Here I am, digging my very own nest, laying my own precious clutch. Yes, I feel ready now, digging in the warm sun. One flipper scoop here, hop, and the other there. The sand must be the right temperature. Not too moist, not too dry. And I remember nesting rule number 1. No tree roots in the nest. Okay, dig deeper. Deeper. Oops, another root. Deeper.
Ouch! I like that. I like that at all. Oh, is you? A nesting turtle. Hey, be careful, you. I can't stand sand in my eyes, you know.
Sorry, Mr. Crapo. It is my first nest, you see. All the turtles told me about you and how humans really hate you. Humans say you are becoming a pest. They say that you are an invasive species. But let me tell you a secret. Wildlife creatures know that actually humans themselves are a very invasive species.
Yes, they invade every space and trash wildlife. And look, nothing can survive after humans pass.
They put concrete roads in the forest.
Parking lots over mangroves.
Airports over reefs and lagoons.
They claim that we are inferior species.
That we do not deserve to live in peace as free as we were born.
They believe wildlife should be locked away in cages.
Kept as pets, as work slaves, or dead. It is so unfair. So sorry, Mr. Crapo. I'll be more careful throwing sand with my flippers. Have a good night.
Oh, this turtle is very well spoken. How could anybody want to hurt such a gentle and knowledgeable creature?
Whoa, I think I hear something. Turtle lane, man. Get closer, then we flip she over, cut off she belly, and take that juicy egg from she womb, right? You know my friends love fresh turtle eggs. Make it kinda strong and young. We know this is against the law, but hey, who sees us now in the dark? Police are sleeping tongue, and if no man catch you, crime never happen, right?
Yeah, man. I got me cutlass sharp and ready. I want that to shell for myself. I know an American who asks me for turtle shell. I polish it and I sell he for plenty money. There she be. Nice one. She barely full of eggs. Slowly, slowly we jump she. One time!
Just in time. The turtle is nesting already. But she's safe now. Phew. They nearly chopped her up.
Poor creature.
Yes, scientists tell us that every turtle alive is important, and these nesting mothers are the only chance for the future of their species. If we protect them now and keep their nesting habitats safe, the hatchlings will find their way to the ocean, and there'll be more turtles around for the future generations. You know, humans and turtles share the same future. We have to help turtles survive as they help us.
And now, before she crawls back to the sea, let us measure her carapace. I mean her shell. Then we tag her flippers. So, if she is found somewhere else in the world, in Africa or South America, then we'll read the tags and learn that she is a Grenada-born turtle. That will protect her. Yes. Measuring carapace 75 centimeters long.
Okay, recorded.
And 63 centimeters wide. Yes.
Yes, recorded too.
We must also give her a name.
Let us see. We'll call her
Turtle Kilo.
Oh, I feel so good now. All my 99 darling eggs are tucked away in the sun and covered. I feel much better now. And these people are so kind. They also gave me a name. I like it. They care for my nest. And I heard them say they will be waiting for the hatchlings to emerge. And they will protect them all the way to the sea. Oh, what's that? It tickles me. Oh, they put an earring on my flipper. It's nice and shiny. Now I can show off my unique tag number to my turtle friends in the far seas. That makes me real special. I feel like a star. Treat me special, please. I am listed as a critically endangered species traveling the planet. So, keep the beaches clean and safe for me. See you soon!
Bye, Turtle Kilo!
I feel free, na 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 na. Feel the ocean belongs to me, yeah, yeah. I feel hungry, na 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 na. Whoa! A jellyfish! Food at last! Jellyfish with a brand name? That's cool! Must be delicious. Ah. Oh, God of the turtles, I'm dying! I'm choking!
Arriba! Arriba! Hola! Hola! ¿Qué pasa, hombre? ¿No está bien?
What?
¿No habla español? ¡Oh, madre de Dios! Another English turtle. Where are you from, my dear?
From Grenada.
Then you must speak Spanish. What's wrong with you?
It's Grenada. Caribbean Sea. Not Granada in Spain. You halfwit?
Hey, I'm not a halfwit. I'm a doctor fish. And I speak several languages, you know. My mission is to warn turtles not to eat plastic bags in the sea. Like you did, the sea is full of plastic bags. Humans think that the ocean is their own private garbage bin.
Well, thanks for the advice, but you arrived a little too late. Fortunately, I managed to spit it out before choking myself to death.
You, amiga, are very, very lucky. Every day I encounter turtles dead in the water. It's so depressing. I come too late. But I cannot save everyone. I need help. Where are you going now?
I'm going to my feeding grounds.
Oh, I wish you good luck. Buona fortuna, my good turtle. And look out for other dangerous. Be smart. Bye.
Bye, Senor Dr. Fish.
Arriba, arriba, arriba. Don't eat plastic bags. Arriba, arriba, arriba.
Hey, psst. You have to stay down. Keep your head down. It is dangerous to float on the surface.
Yes, yes. But I cannot stay underwater forever. I have to breathe air. I have lungs, you know.
All right, so you are not a fish. Well, this is not a place for you then. We have humans on speedboats running and running all day long, faster and faster. Typical human behavior.
Yeah, that propeller nearly chopped me up. I'm pretty hungry, and I have not found my feeding grounds yet.
What do you eat exactly?
Oh, I really prefer sponges, but it is so difficult to find reefs nowadays. I would love to have jellyfish too, but so far I only found plastic bags, and I almost choked on one.
Yeah, yeah, I understand. I do not eat those squeamish things. Yuck. What about crabs? I saw lots of crabs suspended in the water, one after the other. What a strange sight it was.
Hey, thanks. Some crabs would do as well. We can't afford to be very choosy these days.
Okay then, good luck.
Thanks. Looks like we need a lot of good luck and good advice to survive around here.
Please, do not eat me. I'm just bait on a nasty hook.
What? Who spoke? Who are you? Where are you?
I'm here, in front of you. But I beg you, do not eat me. You see, I'm not a selfish crab. I know I'm already going to die, but I do not want more sea creatures to suffer. So, I'm warning them not to bite me. I'm hooked as bait on a 40-mile long line with thousands of hooks and bait. Don't you see? Run away! Run away, my friend! And do not bite any other creature around here. All of them are hooked like me.
Oh, crab! I'm so ashamed that I wanted to eat you. I did not know that you were such a generous creature. What can I do for you? What can I do to help you?
Nothing can be done for me now. Too late. I will reach Crab Paradise pretty soon. But you could do something for all other living creatures. Save the ocean! Save your species! All the endangered species of the world! Be the hero in our dreams!
But Crab, how can I achieve this all alone?
Listen carefully. There is a Grand Ocean Wildlife Council out in the middle of the ocean. Find it! They are working to free the ocean from pollution, from overfishing, and other destructive activities humans have invented and are unable to stop. Join the council and help others! Go, go! Adieu, mon ami!
Yes, I'll find the Grand Council and I will never forget you. To be able to swim, and she's swallowing water. I'm coming. Hold on to me on my back. Yes, I have to find a beach to put this girl, but where? Okay, calm down. Let me turn on my own internal magnetic compass, and I'll navigate right back to my nesting beach. Land, where are you? Are you, dear? Are you okay?
Yes, yes, I'm okay. Who are you? Where am I?
My name is Kido. Turtle Kiddo. You can call me TK. And I just rescued you from drowning. You traveled on my back across the sea for many miles until we reached this beach. In fact, it is my own nesting beach. I hope you'll find someone in the village to look after you.
Oh, dear Turtle, you saved my life. I will never forget you, and I hope to help you one day as you help me.
Thank you, dear. Actually, there are many things you can do to help me. Us, I mean. My species. Other species.
Shipwreck on the shore! Let's go!
I have to go now, but we keep in touch. I'll come back on a full moon night, and we'll talk again.
That turtle saved my life! Believe me, that turtle saved my life!
I feel free, na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Feel the ocean belongs to me. Ah! Ouch! This time, it's really over. I cannot get out of this net. The more I move, the more I get tangled up. Man, I will never reach the Great Council Place. Oh, I'm dreaming now. I will soon reach Turtle Paradise. Plenty of reefs. Plenty of jellyfish. Oh, and dolphins. I see dolphins in Turtle Paradise. Yes, 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 yes.
Wake up, wake up. Don't give up yet. Hold your breath. I'm here. Neptune will be all right.
Oh, are you a dolphin from paradise? Am I dead?
No, no, you are not. And this is not paradise. This is hell. Thousands of nets all over the ocean. How can we swim freely? There's no safe space to go anymore. When I get to the council this year, I'll tell them that we need to get our act together and stop this genocide of the ocean creatures. This is insane! Why do humans not understand that by killing us, they also kill themselves?
Oh, the council. Did we reach? Are we there now?
No, not yet. First I have to cut this net. Help me here. Pull on the other side. There you go. Spit that water from your lungs. Better now?
Yes, yes. Thank you. Much better. Phew. That was a close call.
Hey! I saw a turtle there. And a dolphin. Let's catch them both.
This is a close call. Swim fast, my friend. You must get out of this trap now. To freedom! The council is waiting for us!
Dear friends, I come from Antarctica, which provided all of us creatures with safety and food for millennia. But now the ice poles are melting. Evidence shows that humans are causing the problem. Oh, they make movies about wildlife and talk on their TV shows. Yet they are making our planet unsafe for living, even for themselves. And that, my friends, puzzles me very deeply. Now in the North Pole, even the permafrost is melting.
The perma what?
Permafrost. It's frozen soil, frosted hard by very low temperatures. Part of the life cycle in the northern continent until now, that is.
I hear that polar bears can't find a decent ice floe to keep their babies. Their cubs are starving. Where are the polar bears to go? Where are we all to emigrate? We have rights to live in our own environment with our families and friends too.
I'm sure the fiercest creature in the ocean. No one can compete with us. I know I'm not Mr. Nice Guy, yet we also play a necessary role at the top of the ocean food chain. I'm getting hungry.
Necessary, maybe, but to most of us, very scary.
Shh! When sharks feed, many other species join us in the feast. Because most of us abide to two important principles. Commensalism, which means eating together. And mutualism, exchanging benefits from another species' action. In this case, we sharks kill.
Well, in truth, I did try the first principle, the commensal something, but I nearly lost my tail feathers to a cheeky shark who took me for a chicken. No more of that. I'd rather share the action from the air.
We clean up carcasses. We need it to maintain a healthy ocean. Yet fishes on big ships cut off our fins and throw us back in the sea to sink and die in horrible pain, unable to swim.
It is true. Over 40 million sharks are killed every year, so shark fins end up into rich people's soups. They only respect money.
But I'm asking you, can humans eat money? When all fish is extinct, when ocean earth is empty, what food can their money buy?
Humans are so irrational. Don't be alive with the turtle. Let them speak.
Brothers and sisters of the Wild Ocean Frontiers, dear members of the Grand Ocean Wildlife Council, Your Majesty, the Blue Whale, I have some news to bring to you after my long journey, but I'm afraid it is not good news. You are all familiar with dolphins playing in the ocean with our intelligence and communication skills. We love to play in the surf. We even play with humans. Yeah. We could even do that. Yet again, humans slaughter us by the thousands with their nets and harpoons. And they use our flesh as bait for sharks. None personal, Mr. Shark. Then, to add insult to injury, humans violently catch some of us alive and put us through the torture of imprisonment in small fake blue lakes. In those water prisons, we have to play the jokers, smiling, jumping clowns, to amuse human families who laugh at us and cannot seem to understand that the true reality is that we die of sorrow within 2 years of captivity. People do not know that we're replaced over and over by other prisoners, other sea slaves, because we rather die than live in a prison. Freedom and respect. I beg you, children, do not support the water circus where marine mammals are enslaved.
Dear council members, it feels good to be here. One can feel that intelligence is fully awake in all wildlife. My name is Turtle Kiddo. I'm a hawksbill turtle and I come from Grenada in the Caribbean Sea.
A what? A cock's
a hawk's bill, Bui Paparazzo, because she has a beak like a hawk.
Ah, never heard of it.
I'm 30 years old. I'm proud to say that I delivered my first clutch of eggs almost 2 months ago. But my journey all the way from my nesting beach was full of dangers. I'm still alive because friends of different species saved my life. And I see now that I'm not the only one to suffer the consequences of human action. A green turtle reported that when she returned to nest on her native beach in the Caribbean, she had the shock of her life. The beach was gone. No sand. So she was forced to abort her eggs in the water.
Oh no! What a waste!
A huge tourist resort was to be built on the coast, using the sand and the trees from the area.
Are they all insane?
There is more. A leatherback mother, surfing out onto her beloved nesting beach, knocked her head against a concrete wall built right on the beach. And my hawksbill friend, crawling to nest under her favorite bush, got lost in land on a golf course. Developers cut down all the vegetation.
Who is this, Mr. Developers?
They are people who usually destroy the natural place they want to develop.
What? They should be called destroyers, not developers.
They are definitely destroyers. While humans expand a concrete jungle, their pollution destroys our habitats. We turtles have been around for 150 million years. But we only have 10 years left, unless the killing stops.
Oh no, no, no.
I am the blue whale. Welcome everyone to this Grand Ocean Council. There are only a few hundred of us blue whales left in the ocean. And my brothers and sisters of different whale species suffer a similar fate. We blue whales are the largest animals on ocean Earth. In fact, the largest animals that have ever lived. But we harm nobody. We only eat krill.
Drills? Oh, gosh. Do they really eat drills?
Oh, for goodness sake, Paparazzo. Do not interrupt His Majesty. They eat krill. Very, very, very tiny crab-like creatures called krill.
Ah, I see. Whoa, the biggest animals eat the smallest. Go figure.
And yet, fishers tell people that we eat too much fish. They say it is their ocean, that whales must die. They said that whales are the cockroaches of the sea.
Oh, no, no, no.
But I do have an encouraging, beautiful story to tell you, to show all of us that things may change for the better. Listen. Last season, I was quietly cruising in the cold waters of the Southern Ocean. It was a beautiful day, and there was plenty of krill to boot. Suddenly, I was hunted by a gray steel ship with a cannon on her bow. They were shooting explosive harpoons at me. I swam fast. But after a while, my heart, which as everyone knows is the size of a small boat, started to fault me. I had to slow down. And then, the gray killer ship was above me. I was about to die, and I knew it. Then, as if out of nowhere, between the whaler's cannon and myself appeared a blue vessel, deftly maneuvering to keep the whaling ship away from me. On the deck of the little blue vessel were lots of friendly humans. They were cheering me to dive deeper. Go, blue whale, go, save yourself. To avoid head-on collision, the killer ship had to stop hunting me. So, I took the largest breath I could. And I dove down, down, till I lost myself in the deepest darkness of the ocean. My heart slowed its beats, and only after the longest while, I slowly resurfaced. No blue ship, nor killer ship in sight. I was saved. So, my dear friends, there are also humans who care for freedom, for a healthy and safe environment, without war, without innocent bloodshed. Let us find a way to link with these beautiful humans.
Wow!
Yes, His Majesty said it right. We do have some human friends. Most of them are children. And, of course, ecologists.
Who are those ecologists?
Environmentalists and ecologists are helping us. But there are too few in the world, and they too get harassed, ridiculed, and even killed sometimes when they protest and defend us.
Attention, please. We, the Grand Ocean Wildlife Council, hereby agree to send a wildlife representative all over the world to make contact with humans, to let them know about the urgent situation of planetary ecological imbalance. We have chosen to communicate with children because they seem to understand better the silent common language shared by all wildlife. We must tell the children about our stories, the beautiful stories of whales, of penguins, of marlins and dolphins, of turtles, and all of the other creatures of the ocean.
And land.
And land.
And sky.
And sky. Yes, yes indeed. Children will help us to change the world.
Yes, yes, freedom for all.
Pardon me, Your Majesty, Grand Council members. I wanted to say that I really made the first contact.
Really?
Yes. I rescued a young girl at sea, and she seemed to understand our language, and she asked me how she could help us.
Tatukido. This is fantastic. You must go at once to meet this girl again to bring her our message. Tomorrow will be the full moon night, and all my senses tell me, and I do have extremely good senses, that she will be there on that beach waiting for you. Turtle Kido, I officially nominate you the Ocean Earth Messenger to humanity. Go, Turtle Kido, and spread our word.
I'm honored of the trust you bestow on me. It will be my mission to reach humanity and free it from this global insanity.
I was sure that you would be here tonight. Everyone else is asleep in the village. No one will disturb us now.
Good. I have a very important message to tell you. Oh! Look over here! These are my babies! All coming out of their shells! My only worry is that I do not know how many will survive to reach my age. This makes me very sad.
Don't be sad, Chike. I'm here to help you. I will talk to my people and convey your message. Your wisdom will prevail one day. I love your babies. Look at that one. Isn't he so cute? Or is he a she?
I love them too. That's why I'm here with you tonight, to tell you the message and show you the way. I realize I never asked you for your name.
My name is Hope.
Hello, Hope.
Hello, Tatsukido.
Well, when I return to the Grand Council, I will tell them that I found hope among humanity. And this is the truth. Now, Hope, listen.
I'm listening.
Hello, Turtle Kido, hello. Tell us your story today. Deep in the ocean, I know where you're in. You're the hero in my dreams. Bum, 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 bum.
D for the penguin and S for the shark.
Out in the ocean we go, oh, oh, oh.
B for the blue whale and C for her calf.
D for the dolphin jumping 10 feet high.
Hello, Turtle
Kido, hello. Tell us your story today. Deep in the ocean and over the reef, you're the hero in my dreams.
G for the green turtle, looking so cute.
She's been around for millions of years.
The leatherback nesting in the sand,
and H for the hatchimon in the moonlight.
Hello, Turtle
Kido, hello. Tell us your story today. Deep in the ocean and over the reef, you're the hero